Welcome to Computing, Form, and Shape. My name is Carl Lostritto. My background is architectural, but I've been teaching and practicing across disciplines within design and fine art for around a decade now. My expertise is in the realm of computation. For me, computation, and more specifically the craft of writing computer code, is exciting because it affects not only how we make, but how we think, learn, theorize, and critique our work. By the end of this course, you'll have a basic proficiency programming using the Python language and the Rhinoscript Python library. More importantly, you'll have a conceptual foundation that will allow you to think about your work differently and continue to adapt programming in your practice or artistic research. I expect that many of you are studying in architecture programs. You'll recognize some of my architectural bias, even though this course will keep the subject matter far more abstract than buildings. For others, whether you're a sculptor, set designer, painter, or any other kind of designer or artist, I hope you'll find an architectural take, which will tend to favor ambiguity, relationships, and inhabitable space, refreshingly productive. I found that artists and designers learn best when they are creatively producing. For that reason, this course is structured around projects. This means also that we'll move fast. In a few minutes, you'll write your first few lines of Python code that produces some geometric content. We'll address more programming basics as the course progresses. Before we dive in, I want to make a note about prerequisites for this course. You will need to have a basic working knowledge of Rhinoceros software. And by the way, from here on out, I'll use the shorthand Rhino to refer to this application. You don't need to be a Rhino expert, but you should be comfortable with the interface and some basic modeling tools. We're using Rhino because it's an excellent all-purpose modeling software that doesn't have too much of a bias towards any one discipline. You can use Rhino to model a building or a piece of jewelry. By using the Rhinoscript Python library, we can write Python code while accessing all the commands in Rhino, and we can take advantage of Rhino's robust capacity to display, organize, manipulate, analyze, and export geometry. You're not alone learning Python. One of the reasons I love Python is that it's popular. Besides making me appear cool, its prevalence across many artistic, scientific, and engineering disciplines leads to a wealth of resources available. You find that many common problems and questions are easily searchable online. You'll also find complete documentation for the Python standard library on python.org and the Rhino Python library, which is an add-on to the standard library at rhino3d.com. Those specific links are available in the course materials. I also want to make sure you take use of each other as a resource. The forums offer us an online space to meet and discuss issues directly related to this course. Use them. I encourage you also to post code and use the forums to hone the craft of coding. The final resource I will mention are the project briefs themselves. I recommend you read them before you watch the videos for the corresponding session. The projects aren't designed to make your life hard or to trick you, but rather to stimulate and motivate you to do your best work. I think the videos will make much more sense if you're keeping the project in the back of your mind.